Hey guys, and welcome back to another Shutterstock tutorial. My name is Robbie Janae with Shutterstock.com, and today we're going to be talking about two different types of camera shots, the wide and the close-up shot. Now I know it sounds pretty self-explanatory, right? I mean, one is wide and one is close-up. I mean, these are terms you've learned without even having to step foot in a film class. I mean, if you really combine camera shots into like a singular polarity, I mean, there's really two types of shots, one that is close-up and one that's far away. Now it's the burden of many beginning filmmakers to try to decide what shot they need to execute their vision for their film, but it really boils down to what you want to draw attention to. Now the wide shot's all about drawing attention to large scale objects, you know, like a building or two people having a conversation or even sweeping landscape shots that can bring your audience feelings of awe and wonder of very large scale things brought to a smaller screen. But with a close up, you're dealing with a lot of minute details. So like the human face, there's a lot of emotions and, you know, certain small movements that wouldn't be captured in a wide shot. But with a close up, you can get, you know, a quivering lip or the way eyes are directed somewhere in your shot. Things that whenever brought to large scale can have huge consequences for your shot. So we're gonna take a typical dialogue scene to show you when you should use a close-up and when you should use a wide. Now for a dialogue scene, I highly recommend you don't have your subjects too far.
Or your subject's gonna get lost in the background. Whenever there's dialogue, you want it close and personal.
And especially you don't want your subjects too close.
You're gonna lose all the information that you had in your background, and it's gonna be very jarring for your audience to watch.
Now, if you want to show a connection between two actors, I'd recommend the wide shot. That way, whenever they're conversing, you can see the connection between the two by reactions. One will be talking and the other will be reacting. It's a two-way street that will really connect the audience to those two characters. It's drawing a lot of subconscious feelings that will automatically connect those two characters together in the audience's mind. Now, if you want to draw attention to a certain line of dialogue, I recommend the close-up, because whenever you have a close-up of someone's face, you really can't pay attention to anything else except the dialogue. That's the only thing in frame. Dialogue can also be lost in translation or wide shot, so a close-up can bring that intimacy and familiarity that people draw from seeing a human face deliver information to them. Now you might be wondering, what type of lens do I use to achieve each type of shot? And it's pretty simple, honestly. There's two types of lenses. There's the telephoto lens, and then there's the wide lens. Now the difference between a telephoto and a wide angle lens is the millimeter length of your lens. Now, wide angle lenses will have a length of about like, you know, 7 to 35 millimeters, and a telephoto will have a length of 35 to, say, 400 if you get into the professional ranges, but you'll usually see like a 50 or an 80 or a 85 to 200 telephoto lens. Now this is a Panasonic Lumix with a 25 millimeter wide angle lens, which is perfect for capturing wide shots. You know, it has a very wide frame and can capture a lot of things within that frame while still maintaining cinematic quality. Now this is a Sony A7S with a 50 millimeter lens, which still technically counts as a telephoto lens, even though it's not the white long body ones that you guys probably have seen before, but still this gets good telephoto shots that, you know, can translate to very dramatic close-ups. Another thing you want to take into consideration before deciding if you want a wide or a close-up is the depth of field you want in your shot. Now, a wide shot is going to have a really deep depth of field. Everything's going to be in focus, which is going to draw attention to most everything in the shot. While the close-up is going to have a very shallow depth of field, so it's going to draw attention to very certain things within your frame, but, you know, the other parts of the frame will be blurry. But that also gives you a huge opportunity to showcase very, very minute details of that close-up. So whenever you're deciding whether you want to shoot a wide or a close-up, honestly, shoot both. Good coverage is awesome, and it's great to have, especially in post. Whenever you'd be stressing about, you know, not having a shot, wouldn't it be great if you had all of it? That way, if you change your mind of what feeling you want to convey later on, you can choose between the two of the shots. You'll have them. So if you have any more questions about wides and close-ups, make sure to comment below, and I'll make sure to answer any questions you guys got. And make sure to subscribe as well, because we got great content coming out every single week. I'm Robbie Janae with Shutterstock.com, and we'll see you next time.